This tutorial is about editing an open invoice. To begin, we'll go to the list of invoices. From there, we will select the invoice that we want to edit. And we can see in this invoice, the assigned dollars are not at 100%. We have hail as our only service. So to correct the assigned dollar amount, we will press the blue edit box. This will take us in, and we can either press the split even or press the recalculate and reconfigure all of the hail dollars. We can either press the done or cancel, depending upon what changes that we have made. The split even button will automatically assign 100% to the text assigned to that. Press done when finished. Next, we can go down and see on the services line, and to edit the services, we would click right on the service that is active. Here we can click on an existing panel to edit the dollars within it, or we can select a new panel and add that into our invoice. All of the editing works exactly the same as writing the original estimate. When finished, click the Done. If you need to add an additional service, you can do so just simply by clicking on the Add Service line. This will take you straight into the Services section of MTRX, and you can select any of the services and add those right into your invoice. When finished, make sure you press the Done button. And if you would like, you can add photos now into your invoice simply by clicking on the Add Photos. Then just select the appropriate photo boxes, add your photos, and make sure that you press the Done when finished. Anytime you make changes to any of the dollar figures in that invoice, you will need to re-edit the assigned dollars. So you can go back in and just quickly hit the split even and press the done button to put the dollars back to 100%. To remove the work order from the invoice, we will bring up the right side menu and press remove vehicle. From there, we need to select the vehicle that's being removed and press the remove box. Say yes to the pop-up, no if you did not mean to touch that. This will remove the work order and leave the invoice with zero work orders. Then we need to go back to the work order list. Then we can find the work order that needs to be put into that invoice. Open that work order. Click the invoice button in the lower right corner and make sure I add it into the invoice of the proper number, and that invoice will finally be complete. If I need to add a PO, we just click the PO box and add our PO number. Thanks for watching. Please like us and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hope you have a great day.